Swami Satyeshwarananda Vidyaratna Babaji's meetings with Divine Himalayan Yogi Mahamuni Babaji. Mahamuni Babaji does not have a normal human body. During the 12-year period, Swami Satyeshwarananda Vidyaratna Babaji, popularly known as Baba, was living at Dunagiri Hill. Many times the Divine Himalayan Yogi visited him. The happenings of one such visit was as follows. One evening, Baba was sitting outside, gazing at the Bharat Kot Hill, when Babaji arrived from the forest side. Baba received him with pranam, bowing. Then both went into the holy hut, the temple of silence, where Baba arranged the cave for Babaji. Babaji entered the cave. The next morning, Baba prepared suji with semolina, sugar and milk and offered it to Babaji. His body is beyond the rules of nature and as such does not need food, yet Baba offered it as he learned to do so from Mataji. Babaji accepted it kindly. The following evening, Babaji proposed to move. Mahamuni Babaji, I would like to take you somewhere now. Narayan, you will accompany me. Baba, now this body understands why you call Narayana before. Mahamuni Babaji, you will see some scenes of Narayana, Baba's previous life, there. Baba, it would be very interesting. Mahamuni Babaji, well, let us go. Babaji came out of the hut. Baba locked the hut and left a message for Govinda Singha to look after the hut. Babaji created a balloon out of the sky using a yogic process. Mahamuni Babaji, close your eyes and concentrate between the eyebrows. Baba closed his eyes and concentrated between the eyebrows. Babaji took Baba in his arms, and Baba had the feeling as if his body levitated from the ground and they were moving forward in the sky while his legs hung limply. After some time, they landed from Clairportation. Atibahik Airborne System. Baba, Babaji, it seems that we are in Bengal. Is it not so? Mahamuni Babaji, we are. Look, here is a hermitage where you lived with an old Swami. Baba, it seems we are clairported about 1300 miles. What is the name of this place, Babaji? Mahamuni Babaji, it is Sanyasgar, place of sannyasi or swami or renunciates. Sanyasgar, where Babaji made Kayakalp, changed his body. Babaji, where does the old Swami live? Mahamuni Babaji, let us go see him. We entered a room where the bulky old Swami, about 75 years old, was sitting and his young student was attending him. Mahamuni Babaji, do you recognize this young student? Baba, no. Mahamuni Babaji touched the top of Baba's head and Baba remembered his previous life. The young student, Narayana, was from Baba's previous life. Baba, this is the life of this body. Is it not? Mahamuni Babaji, yes, this is your previous life. Look at this old Swami. He will leave his body. Baba, what is the name of this Swami? Mahamuni Babaji does not use any name. Baba, by what name do people or his disciples call him? Mahamuni Babaji, Bhagavan, Maheshwar Baba, Maheshwarananda, Sadhu Baba, Babaji, etc. Kai Kalp, changing the body through a yogic process. Baba, how will the old Swami leave the body? Mahamuni Babaji will perform Kaikalp. Baba, what is Kaikalp? Mahamuni Babaji, it is changing the body through a yogic process. Watch him. The old Swami informed his young student, Narayana, that he was going to leave the body. Narayana prayed for one word promise, that the old Swami would give him a darshan, meeting, when Narayana would leave his body. The old Swami promised and asked for some relevant articles, Nabidya, for ritual worship. The old Swami exhaled loudly and a kind of white, thread-like material began coming out of his mouth. He caught it by his hand and drew it out. He cut it into three pieces. After pausing to perform ritual worship, Homa or Jejna, he held one piece in his hand, chanted some hymns and mantras and dropped it in the fire of the Homa or Jejna. Then he took the second piece of the thread-like breath, chanted hymns and mantras and placed it into the fire. Finally, he took the third piece and followed the same routine, but this time he did not put it in the fire but simply carried it near the fire and ate it. After a while, the old Swami's belly began to swell. It got bigger and bigger until it burst. A bright, young body, radiant in character, came out from the belly of the old Swami. The bright, radiant young body took the dead body of the old Swami and threw it into the fire of the ceremony, Homa, and left the place. It was very surprising for Baba to see that the body, which came out from the old Swami's belly, and Babaji's body, which was standing beside Baba, looked identical. It became clear that the old Swami was Babaji and that the body, which he changed through the yogic process Kaya Kalp, was his present body, young, bright and radiant. As it was made through a yogic process, it remained free from the laws of nature. Baba, Babaji, the old, changed body of the Swami was identical with yours. Would you kindly comment on this? Babaji looked into Baba's eyes and smiled gently. Baba, it means you were in Bengal. Would you kindly tell me where that old Swami's body was born? Babaji remained silent. He refused to comment. The place is called Sanyasgar, but also Govindanagar, possibly for the old Swami as he was called Govinda Bhagavan. There is a Govinda temple there. It may have been built in his memory. At present there is a hermitage near Govindanagar at Sanyasgar. Once Babaji wanted to leave the body but at the request of his sister, Mataji, he agreed to keep it for indefinite period of time.